Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome to another tutorial of Benjamin Felix Graphic Recording. So this time it's about chisel tips again. I hope you watched the last tutorial and make your first are now fully trained and experienced with working with the chisel tip, because this time I want to take the writing, the lettering, to a next level, and that's why you should be a bit familiar with using a chisel tip. And maybe you are. If you're not, you can also watch the other video or just stay here, stick around, and see if you manage to follow along. And today I'm going to show you 5 different fonts that you can write with, that you can use with using a chisel tip. And in the end, we're gonna make a small Christmas lettering sign, because it's December, it's Christmas time, and that's why we have a little Christmas sign at the end. So let's start and dive directly into the exercise. Good, here I have my paper and here's my marker. Whoop, 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 whoop. And of course it's a chisel tip marker, so it has on the one side it's a bit wider and one side it's a bit smaller, wider, smaller. And I'm gonna use now the different sides to give my handwriting a little bit of an effect. So there's like different versions. So what I'm going to do is that I'm using either one, like the thin side or the thick side. So I turn the marker like this for an eye, or I use both sides at once. So I start with the thin side, go over the turn over to the thick side, and go over to the thin side again. Or I start thin and then later I correct it with the thick side, with the white side of the chisel tip. And those are the techniques we're going to use. So we're going to use the thin side, we're going to use the thick side, mix directly or mix afterwards. And this is what we need for now for the different fonts. And I want to introduce the fonts to you now. The first font I want to show you is, I call it a condensed font. So you take just the thin side and you write very narrow. So a bit high and narrow. And you use your chisel tip on the small side like this, and you write very narrow, and also the S is very narrow. I'm going to write the word chisel now in 5 different type forms. So this one is called condensed. I'm going to put it here because we need this one later. So it's condensed. Oh, I can't see it like this. Here it's condensed. So I write now condensed here. Next version I want to show is like we start to mix. So we start to mix thin lines and thick lines, and I call this Roman. And the usually I can do it live, but everywhere where there's a letter that has round forms, I have to go over twice. So I start here with the Z now. So, and then thicken it on one side, and usually it's the basic technique that I also showed in another video, where like you always have the technique that where there's an upward stroke you stay thin, and where there's a downward stroke you get thick. And so now I'm going to continue with the word, and so I write the H now, then the I, then there's a round form again, so I have to do it in 2 times. So now the S, try to thicken it on the right spot. Now the E, and again the end, the L. And I call this Roman because you can either leave it like this, or what you also can do is that you add now serifs here. Serifs, so you can make like those little ornaments here on the top of the letters, and then you have a nice serif font quite easily. Good, the next one is, I call this sign painting, and in my other tutorial where I showed how to write with a chisel tip, I said that when you are right-handed you should have the chisel in a way that when you make a downward stroke, let's place it here, that you should have it in a 45 degree angle. And this time, so that you have always the same angle when you make the downward stroke. And for the next font I want to show, I want to turn it. So it's kind of a bit tricky, it's because you have to turn it now. And now I'm going to turn it, and I'm also go a little bit italic. And I want now to have the look of, it's like a, I call it a sign painting. So it's I draw this C like this. And like you see, I stay a bit italic. And I make always this S or the C starting with this, or like a G with a little, how do you say, with a little extra line here. Close it. And again, stay in the angle. And also with the last letter, stay in the angle. So that you have kind of, and what's really important here is like when you are those things here, those little lines from the at the top at the C and the S, and you also have it at the G, because this makes like this typical characteristics of a sign painter type font, sign painter. And now we are going to use a double technique again, where I start with a thin line and then I go over with a thick line. And this is going to be a script. So I draw a script, and like always when you have script, when you have like a false calligraphy, it's called here, I'm going to write first the word nicely in a script, as nice as I can, today, like this. And then I go over again, like before, everywhere where I make a downward stroke, I just use the white side of the of my chisel tip marker and make the downward stroke a bit thicker. This needs a bit of a practice, because you kind of have to know where, how to hold the chisel tip marker. But once used to it, you can make a false calligraphy quite quickly, and a false calligraphy. And so we have here the script now. So this is the script. And lastly, we're going to use this technique, so we stay bold all the time. And this is kind of tricky, because you have to turn the pen all the time. It's not so easy, as you see. But it also has a nice look and feel to it. And then you can also be very bold and have a very nice display. And I call this bold or display. And actually, there's a colleague of mine, a colleague and friend, Heather Martinez from the US. She is really good in she also calls herself corporate graffiti art. And Let's Letter Together is her homepage. And on the Newland site, you can download a practice sheet with different fonts, and she also has like this kind of bold font where she directly shows you how to make the strokes, and that's really awesome. And she also has a lot of online classes and workshops, and this practicing sheet here that you can download, I will put the link into the description, is amazing when you want to expand your abilities on how to draw with chisel tip markers or brush pens, and she has like some alphabets really nicely where I can follow along. But like, those are the fonts that I want to show you now. So it's like the condensed font, the Roman font, the sign painter, the script, and the bold and display font. And we're going to use those fonts now to make a little small yet nice Christmas sign. Ta-da! There's a new paper, and we're going to use the different types that we had before, like the condensed, Roman, sign painter, script, bold, and display, also here to make a nice Christmas sign. And yeah, let's start. Let's start with condensed, meaning you go on the thin side of your chisel tip marker, and we are going to write Mary. We're going to write Mary. That's it, basically. So we write Mary here. It's the first word we're going to write. Then we switch over to Roman. And we're going to write Christmas, and we're going to make use of both sides of the thin side and the thick side. And so again, like I make the downward stroke from Xmas, from Christmas, I made it thick, and upward stroke, I made it basically, or like the line going up here, I made it thin. And again, when I make now the M, I can do this basically in one. So I go up thin, down thick, up thin, down thick, up thin, down thick, make a little line here. And then of course, when it comes to the S, I have to do it, unfortunately, in two times. I'm also not skilled yet that I could do it in one. And let's make some serifs here. So when I do serifs, I first make the top line, then I make the bottom line, try to have it all in one. Xmas. Then let's go for the sign painter. For the sign painter, I want to make it a bit smaller. So I turn out the nib again, and I write 2. And also turn again the pen. Sometimes you have to go over a little bit to make it look nice. Finish even with the very tip. That's what I did here. 2. Now we go to the script. And the script I make a bit bigger because it's Merry Christmas to you all. So I make the U quite thick. So here's the U. And like I said before, also here, everywhere I go over it again, everywhere where there's a downward stroke, I take the white side of my marker and finish it that it has a nice look to it, a nice calligraphic look. And then in the end, I go for the bold and display. So that's quite easy because it's just very geometric rectangular forms here. So they're all is nice. Good. And now you see the use, how you could combine those different fonts you have here. But I'm gonna now make a small frame around it. Also using a chisel tip. Yeah, and that's basically it. So, Merry Christmas to you all, and I hope you learned a bit. Now today, using a chisel tip and with turning and twisting and holding, you have different options that you can use now to get a bit more variation into your lettering. All right, and yeah, another tutorial here of Benjamin Felis. I hope you liked it. I hope you can now use your chisel marker a bit in more variations, and of course take some practice to get used to twisting and turning. You also see that I'm not in all of the letters are super safe with it, but it's cool. It goes quite fast and it gives you a wider variety to make nice headlines, quotes, whatever in your graphic recording, sketch noting, picture process. Cool. If you liked the video, of course, give it a like, subscribe to the channel if you want to learn more. And apart from that, I wish you great holidays, have a nice Christmas time with your friends and family, as long as it's allowed, it's COVID time. But stay safe, stay healthy, and see you next time. This was Ben. Bye.